An analysis of 10 different species finds that humans, followed by ferrets and to a lesser extent cats, civets and dogs, are the most susceptible animals to SARS-CoV-2 infection. A single protein is a master regulator of mouse muscle function during aging, a new study finds. Blocking this protein increased muscle strength and endurance in old animals. It may play a role in age-related muscle weakening in humans. The global collapse of frogs and other amphibians due to the amphibian chytrid fungus exacerbated malaria outbreaks in Costa Rica and Panama during the 1990s and 2000s, according to new research. The findings provide the first evidence that amphibian population declines have directly affected human health and show how preserving biodiversity can benefit humans as well as local ecosystems. mass extinctions of land-dwelling animals, including amphibians, reptiles, mammals, and birds, follow a cycle of about 27 million years, coinciding with previously reported mass extinctions of ocean life, according to a new analysis. The provision of accurate and authoritative statistical information strengthens our society. It provides a basis for decisions to be made on public policy, such as determining electoral boundaries and where to locate schools and hospitals. It also allows businesses to know their market, grow their business, and improve their marketing strategies by targeting their activities appropriately. It is precisely in observing the intertwinings of success and failure that chasing the flame makes its greatest mark. With piercing insight and relentless logic, it reveals the pitfalls of international politics and details an intricate struggle between individual and institution. It haunts us with the poignant truth that even a great man can do only so much to reinvent the world. Scientists have recommended actions the government of Madagascar's recently elected president, Henri Rajoelina, should take to turn around the precipitous decline of biodiversity and help put Madagascar on a trajectory towards sustainable growth. Madagascar's protected areas, some of the most important for biodiversity in the world, have suffered terribly in recent years from illegal mining, logging, and collection of threatened species for the pet trade. There are two main types of market research. Quantitative research involves collecting a lot of information by using techniques such as questionnaires and other forms of survey. Qualitative research involves working with smaller samples of consumers, often asking them to discuss products and services, while researchers take notes about what they have to say. We all know about bacteria, viruses, and microscopic protozoa. We can watch the way that these tiny agents move into our bodies and damage our organs. We have a growing understanding of how our body mounts defensive strategies that fight off these invaders, and have built some clever chemical that can help mount an assault on these biovillains. Credit unions are non-profit organizations that were imported to the United States from Germany in the early 1900s. They were regulated in 1934 by the Federal Credit Union Act, which limits membership to groups having a common bond of occupation or association. Groups from particular geographical areas also were eligible to join credit unions. This course provides an introduction to the history and development of the British legal system. Its aim is to describe the evolution of the common law of England, the legal system of England, and to introduce you to the study of constitutions as law and to the legal aspects of constitutional systems of government. This is an extremely useful resource, which ranks books and academic papers on the subject not only in terms of their reliability, but also their readability. As a result, it is likely to save a student's time and effort that would otherwise have been spent working through a lot of dense text before finding the one they really need.
Thus, language acquisition might be like other biological functions. The linguistic clumsiness of tourists and students might be the price we pay for the linguistic genius we displayed as babies, just as the decrepitude of age is the price we pay for the vigor of youth.
The coronavirus pandemic has shifted many of our interactions online, with Zoom video calls replacing in-person classes, work meetings, conferences, and other events. Will all that screen time damage our vision? Maybe not. It turns out that our visual perception is highly adaptable, according to new research.
Researchers have conducted a study that has determined the role that a critical protein plays in the development of hair cells. These hair cells are vital for hearing. Some of these cells amplify sounds that come into the ear, and others transform sound waves into electrical signals that travel to the brain.